sing, but I can't speak. I'm paralyzed when you're next to me, running on dreams, cause I can't see how this could be reality. You're holding me close, and I don't know. Do I let you in? Do I let it show? All of my fears and all of my ghosts are the only thing I've ever known.
Happy Monday. Welcome back to Morning Coffee. I'm your host, Rick Alexander. Thanks again for tuning in or listening to all of these episodes. Coming up on 400 episodes on this channel. Of course, we started as Lionheart Radio and we moved to Morning Coffee as we sort of, it mirrored the transformation that I went through of having my focus really in endurance and sports, and then having my focus shift to some of the psychology and personality things and things that happen or occur between the ears that we're always kind of trying to make sense of. And that was me. I felt like I was always trying to make sense of it. And of course, throughout that period and of trying to make sense of the things that were occurring between my ears, I came up with all kinds of different practices. And of course, the Clarity Academy is an expression of that, right? Those were a lot of the lessons that I learned in that period of trying to figure out who I really was and what I wanted. And then on top of that, like, I really nailed down a journaling practice, which I stick to today. Very rarely do I miss a morning of journaling. It's just how I make sense of the world. And right now we're still continuing a series where I'm going back through my journals, like kind of 6 months worth of, well, really just 6 months worth of transformations. And I'm picking out the lessons that really moved me. And this one is something that I've kind of come back to as of lately. And the first time I actually journaled on this was back in March. But I guess what we'll do is we'll start with a statement, which is how you communicate is how you are. Now, I want to break that down a little bit because a lot of times, well, first of all, it's a hard thing to get your mind around, right? But so if you think about it, the edge of your expression as a human is your communication. And so if you have thoughts about something, you know, something I say on here a lot is if you're in thought, you're not in reality. Okay, you could be thinking about reality, but you're not engaging with it. And the way that you engage with it is by communication. And so as you're thinking about things in your life that you might want to do, just remember, if you don't figure out the way to or the ability to articulate them, then they're going to get stuck in your head and it's going to be very hard to manifest them into reality, right? And so communication is a huge part of making your dreams come true or figuring out what it is that you want for this life and then actually going to attain it. Like, communication is the bridge between what you want and understanding how you get it. It's like, you know, kids, they really start to cry. Like, if you look at a baby or you're around a baby for enough time, you see that kids like really start to cry when they can't articulate what it is that they want because they're frustrated. And if you want to understand adults, just start right there, right? Because a lot of us are frustrated with our lives and we're frustrated with the things that we're going, but we don't have the ability to articulate what it is that we're going through. And, you know, here's another thing that I have kind of come across in the Clarity Academy, and this might be something for you to really think about, is you have a truth in this life and you have a deep truth. A lot of times people don't think through the implications of their beliefs, but you do believe things. You believe that you need things, you believe things about the world, but we're so afraid to stand on our own truth, right? Because part of that is the responsibility of having to trust ourselves and be wrong sometimes. And then part of that, though, is that, like, there always seems to be an implied narrative about what's acceptable in our life and in the different settings that we find ourselves in. So if you're in work, if you're in a job setting, if you're in a school setting, an educational setting, like, there are expectations of what's okay. And so if you have a truth that might run counter to that expectation, it's really hard. We suppress it. You don't want to communicate it because it's really difficult to communicate it. And you'll feel a lot of dissonance, like really deep in your heart around trying to communicate it. So that's something to know about yourself, because the challenge when you have a truth that runs counter or you want to live in a different way, the challenge is communicating that to other people so that you can still feel safe and you don't feel ostracized when you try to step out and live a different way. You know, because all of us we'll have such nuances and subtleties that separate us and all these ideas about how our life could be different or could be better. But it's not just about stating what those are, right? That's like, again, how you communicate is how you are. And so if you want to be brutish and encumbered, then yeah, all you have to do is state what you are, state what you want. But there's an eloquence and a grace to communication, and there's a give and take of energy. And so the reason I'm saying this is we don't put a lot of effort into our communication style, but we really should. We should learn what people need in order to feel centered and heard and listened to. And a lot of that starts with values, because if you understand someone's value, you can, or values, you can speak to them, right? And then they have a sense of being heard and understood. And so you have to take that into account when you're trying to communicate your vision and the things that you want to do with your life, right? Because it's not just, hey, here's what I want to do, because of course people aren't going to accept it. They're not conditioned to. It's your job to communicate and articulate the vision as you move through reality so that people are comfortable with what your vision is. And then furthermore, so that you can get what you want out of it, right? It's not manipulative. It's that you have things that you want to do, but in order to get them out, you have to be able to communicate them far better. And you have to make people know you and like you and trust you. And that's all communication. You know, and then the second or last part of that is the question that I really want you to ask yourself today is, like, you have needs, right? And maybe you know what they are, maybe you don't, but you should figure out what it is that you need to feel centered, and you need to feel heard, and you need to feel good about who you are and to be in your value set, and so that you stop living reactive and everybody else's problems don't become your emergency. See, we grow up as people pleasers and we tie all this nobility into being a people pleaser. But the reality is that if you could step into who you are fully, then the person that you are, you'd have so much more impact on the world around you, and that would give you more of a sense of meaning. But all of that starts with you communicating what it is you need and communicating it in a way that doesn't seem like what I need is taking away from what you need. Because an abundant mentality would say that there are plenty of everything in this life to go around. And so the question for you to ask yourself again today is, what needs do I have that I'm not getting met right now? And then how can I articulate those needs in a way so that I actually can start getting them, so that I can show up as a better person, so that I can impact the world in a better and more authentic way? That's the work. That's the work around communication, because you have needs, you have truths, you have beliefs, and they could be really helpful to other people. And you could be really helpful to other people if you could center yourself and you could get aligned and get what it is that you want out. But you have to be able to articulate it. You have to be able to communicate it, because again, how you communicate is how you are. So enjoy thinking through this one for the rest of your day. I hope you guys have an amazing day. I love you. We'll talk tomorrow on Morning Coffee.
I'm just a sailor swimming backwards. I'm just a fish out in the sea. I'm just a preacher in the graveyard, telling everyone but God to follow me. I'm just a liar who got lucky. I ain't no different from the rest. I might be jaded and delusional, but at least I found the home inside my head. This is for all the dreams I believed in. This is for all the doubts in my mind. This is a wild, wild world that we live in. I won't let anyone tell me I won't survive. I'll be just fine. I'll be just fine. I miss the permanence of failure. I miss the honesty of pain. But I've severed ties with all my anger, so I guess it's just the world we'll have to blame. This is for in my mind. This is the last
damn thing that I hold close to me. I won't let anyone so wrong tell me what's right. And this is for those dreams I believe in. This is for those doubts in my mind. This is a wild, wild world that we're living in. I won't let anyone so wrong tell me what's right. I'll be just fine. Tell me that I ain't fine.